All right, how do we draw an eye? Okay. So, first thing you want to start with when you're drawing an eye is you want to draw the circle that goes for the skeleton of the eye, okay? The socket, basically. And then you want to think about the eye being a cover that goes across this socket. So, this is the whole eyeball I'm looking at, all right? And then the first thing I like to do is think about right here is my tear duct, okay? Then in relation to the eye, I think about the iris. So the iris is a lot bigger than we give it credit for a lot of times, all right? Then we want to think about from the iris to the edge of the eye, okay? So we want to get a general arching shape and then a falling shape, okay, to receive that arch for the eye, okay? Then we want to look how the eye kind of dips up here and then it drops back and goes underneath. Now this fold needs to go over top of the eye. I'm going to bring that down just a little bit more too. All right. Now when you think about the bottom of the eye, it has a double fold just like you see here. All right. Now, some people's eyes arch a little higher, some people's eyes arch a little lower, depending on the nationality. Now, I'm going to come in here, build in my iris that goes into that eye socket. Now, here is my tear duct. A lot of people that are beginners will mess this part up. So you want to really make sure you give yourself a nice tear duct. Now, depending on the nationality, again, some people's tear ducts are very easy to see. Some people's tear ducts are not. Asian people's tear ducts seem to be a fold, okay? And some African Americans have very similar eyes to Asian people's eyes, all right? English, Spanish tend to have larger tear ducts. So you wanna look at that tear duct because that really does kind of set up the way we look at the eye, okay? Next, we wanna look at the way we think about the iris. Now the iris is a nice circle, okay? Once you add that circle, the eye comes to life. Beforehand, it was just funky shapes, but now it's starting to add some dimension, okay? This area is always dark, all right? Then there is a fold that starts above the eye, and it breaks across, but it starts to thin down as it goes across the eye. All right. Now, as you are building up your eye and the shape of the eye, okay, it's fitting within this shape. That's the goal, all right? Now, some people's irises are a little smaller, some people's irises are a little larger, all right? You just kind of have to look on relationship of how big is it fitting within the fold of the eye, okay? Now, comes the important part of the way that this all comes together. When you think about the lines that are in the eye, they start from the iris working outward in a circular motion. All right, I do one line going all the way around. Then I come back from the iris edge and I relate those lines. And I literally overlap them. If I'm looking at a high res or very detailed image, going in the similar pattern. All right. Now, if this person has blue eyes, this portion is going to get a lot of detail. If they are brunettes and they have dark brown eyes or really, really rich almost like a really dark not purple, but dark brown, that is almost where it's almost black, you will not see all those lines, okay? Now, when I'm looking here at the eyes and I'm going to build up the shape, if this room is very dark, this iris is larger. If this room is very light, well, then this iris is very small, okay? Now, and you want to make sure that the same iris size is in both eyes. Now, you see a lot of people doing, like, Disney loves to do those little flares and any Japanese animation. To be honest, there is flares in the eye, but they're not always noticeable, okay? We want to make this as realistic and less about the flares, all right? It is a nice little touch, but it's not always needed, all right? Now, the next part is the eyelashes. Now, when you draw eyelashes, they come all the way across, and then they go up. And they're in a swooping motion. They are never like straight lines coming off the eye. They always come in a nice curve motion. And they get more clumped together as they start to go down the side of the eye. And they always seem to bridge out here in that shape. All right. Now, once you kind of get the structure down of the eye, and of course this is a very close-up view, all right, you then can do the bottom part. Now the bottom part, they flare out at the base here, and they come in a very small line shape. But you only do about half of them, all right? All right, because then as they get over here, it starts to look funky, all right? Now, when you were thinking about our eye, I'm going to angle this so it's a little easier for me to draw. So now I'm going to build my overlay that goes over the eye. And really, I'm going to boost up those lines now. I've kind of set them in motion. Okay. Now, I'm going to come in here and build up my tear duct. And get the inside of that eye and a little bit on the outside. Now there's sometimes some people will have a few wrinkles here. We want to kind of accentuate those, but not make them too dramatic. All right. People get really subconscious about wrinkles on their eyes, especially the older the person is, especially some ladies. You want to make sure you don't age them too much. Now, when you think about these white portions, they are white, but they do have a shadow that goes up underneath that eye. So I always recommend take your finger and rub that little tone that's inside there to boost that shadow. That helps set the eye. Right now it looks like it's kind of dirty at this point. As I come in to clean it, it will get better with that shape. I feel like I got that too small and too much on the width on that. So now I'm going to come in here and I'm going to darken up my iris a lot more. But this time I'm going to start to leave little informations like we talked about, that for those that people love, they love those little dots of light that produce in the eye. If you see those and you like it, pull them out. Now I'm going to say up here it's going to get a lot darker. And always on the edge of our iris, it is quite dark on everybody's iris. So if you have ever looked at yourself in the mirror up close, look at the side of your iris. There is a little bit of a black ring that goes around your iris. And then as I start to build that shape in, I can now take my eraser. So I just got a simple kneaded eraser here. And I can pull out any highlights that I'm seeing in the eye. So if I'm seeing a little bit of light there, I want to bring that light source in. I'm going to bring some of my white light around that edge and just soften this up just ever so slightly. All right. get rid of my line here. All right, because the eye really, after here, it starts to get a cheek structure there. Now, right above the eye, right where the tear duct is about where the eyebrow begins, okay? And it goes in an upward motion at this point, and then it comes at a downward motion. Now, some people's eyebrows have a nice arch to them. Some people's eyebrows are not arched, okay? Some people's eyebrows are more straight. But they still always have a sense of an arch to them, even when they're straight. Okay, it just depends on the nationality of that person. All right, but that usually gives a little bit of break and it helps get the shaping of the face. Now, right in here is a large amount of shadow generally, and another large amount of shadow. A little bit of shadow underneath here and a little bit of shadow here. So I'm going to take my hand at this point and start to shadow that shape in. As you get close to that bone that's in between the nose, there is a shadow there. Okay, and this is what helps bring that bridge of that nose in. And that eye starts to look a little bit more realistic at this point. And as I start to darken this up, and any woman who's ever done eye makeup, you know how to accentuate your eyes to make those lines pop out. Now, some women have a lot of mascara on when they're doing their eyelashes. And that's nice to put accentuations in. But when you think about a male's eye, depending on the color of his hair, if he's blonde-headed, he's probably not going to have really dark eyelashes. So you want to make those eyelashes a little bit lighter and not press down so hard if you're doing a black and white drawing to give you that accentuation of their skin tone and their lightness, okay? But again, even if they do have dark eyelashes, okay, and they're a male, you want to be a little bit conscious because males don't want to look like they're wearing mascara. So you want to make sure you make their eyes have a nice strength to them, but at the same time, not feel like they are, feminine. Okay, so when I look at this eye, and it always helps to look at an image. These eyebrows are way too short for my first line. So now all the hair lines are going to go this direction. And then when it gets to about here, it starts to come this direction. So turn your pencil and the edge of your page and go in that direction. And you can start to see how that foam, that light is starting to hit going across there. If you wanted to accentuate a little bit more light, you could in the eye and come across. But always leave a nice little bit of a shadow underneath that eye to bring that out. And you can add a little bit of dark spots because there are dark spots in an eye. Now this is a person with kind of light colored eyes. All right, and if it was somebody that was darker, I'd come in here and I would come in and start shadowing out my shapes. Leaving the illusion that those lines are there, but at the same time, giving that area a nice dark feel. Even then, lightening up that little bit right there makes that still stand out. And if you come back in with your eraser, just give it a light little hit. You can kind of accentuate some of that light source bouncing off of that eye. So, as you look at the eye, it feels good. It feels like it fits on the page. And it feels right. So the next part is how to draw two eyes and working in unison.